November, our worst December. Just watch those icicles fall. What do I care if icicles fall? I've got my love to keep me warm. Off with my overcoat, off with my gloves. I need no overcoat. My heart's on fire, the flame grows higher, so I will weather the storm. What do I care how much it may storm? I've got my love to keep me warm.
I hear it.
My God, don't go down there.
Call the police.
Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, protect us.
Just the man I wanted to see.
Sorry, Louie. End of the month. I'm running on fumes.
No, it's not money. You see CNN tonight? Record-setting cold front coming in. It's gonna be colder than a witch's what? Can I sleep in a church?
There you go, Lisbon.
Louie, we're not zoned for it, all right? We're troubled with the city on permits already.
You've spoken like a true bureaucrat, Father. Listen, I have something to offer you in exchange for sleeping in a church. Something you can't resist.
What?
Your immortal soul. Come your blessing into the kingdom. What you do for the least of these, my brethren, you do for me. You know who that's about? That's about me. Now, you want to get into the kingdom or not?
Ray, your father shot your brother.
What?
I'll tell you about it in the car. Come on.
Ray, well, what about the parish?
Hold down the fort.
But Martin's gone. Who's in charge?
You are, Eric.
I am?
Father.
Hey, Louie.
You see CNN tonight?
What?
Well, we got them both here now. Your father's on a weapons charge and your brother for breaking and entering.
Not in the same cell, I hope.
You put your father in the cell. The chief's a respected man around here. Yeah. It's a hero.
Yeah, it's a hero, all right. How's my brother?
Your father just winged him. But, the cat wasn't so lucky.
Dead?
Dead.
So it's not all bad news.
Look, you're a priest. I mean, that's supposed to be like Jesus, right? Can't you do something for your family?
What people forget about Jesus is that he ran away from home when he was 13. He did.
Hey, Frankie.
Don't call me that.
That's the name I gave you. Francis Xavier. Great missionary. Of course, I wouldn't have named you that if I knew you were going to take it so literally.
Yeah. I knew your life of crime would catch up with you sooner or later.
Had to happen. How you doing?
Fine, fine.
How you doing?
Fine. Things are fine.
How you doing, Frankie?
Rotten. They brought another priest to keep an eye on me, so this is about the last thing I need right now.
Perfect time for your brother to show up, huh? What I don't get is what the hell I'm doing in jail. He was the one breaking in.
Well, I told you not to keep a gun in the house. It makes Mom nervous.
I got the gun because your mother was nervous about the neighborhood.
Dad, you could have killed him.
If I was going to kill him, I would have done it years ago. Where the hell is she with the bail?
Look, I'm trying to get the police to forget about the whole thing. It was an accident. Was an accident, wasn't it?
I'm going to press charges.
Dad, Mike's a two-time loser. This could put him away for a long time. You don't want to do that, do you?
And if you're going to bail him out, leave me in. Because the next time I see him, if I've got a gun, what happens might not be an accident.
I'll think about it.
Hey, Frankie, get me out of here, huh? I feel like a jerk.
I don't know. I don't like having you locked up.
He shot me, Ray. Can you believe that? The bastard shot me.
Oh, Mike, you were breaking and entering.
You can't break into your own house.
Then what were you doing? Oh, come on. Knocking off a liquor store, that's one thing, but your own house?
What? You've never forgot your keys. You've never come in through a window.
So you ring the bell.
I didn't want to wake him up. Here I am. I'm trying to be considerate. And he shoots me. And Han knew who it was when he shot me, too.
No, he didn't.
How do you know that?
Because he's a good shot and you're still alive. And don't call him Han. You know he hates that.
You know what? He should have thought of that before he gave me so much of the back of it.
Mike, what did you come back here for?
You know, maybe I had some good news and I wanted to surprise him.
What? What good news?
I'm getting married. I'm getting married and I wanted to tell them.
You're getting married? Man, that's...
What?
You're not getting married. You just came back for that ring.
Officer, I got a right to that ring. Mom promised it to whichever one of us got married first. You're out of the running.
I don't care about the ring, Mike. Whatever she wanted to do with it, I can guarantee she didn't want to pawn it off to support your drug habit.
You can't let him press charges, Ray. Talk to him.
Talk to him yourself.
Hey, come on, man. We made a deal, remember? We were going to start over. I'm trying to get married. I'm trying to do my part.
Are you, Mike?
Ray. Ray!
Thanks.
I called Eric, told him we're staying overnight. What's up here?
Well, my father may or may not have shot my brother. On purpose. My brother may or may not be getting married, and my brother may or may not have broken into my parents' house to steal some jewelry.
Well, now that we got that cleared up.
You know I tell the truth all the time, Leo. It's just easier.
Well, what's to be done here?
Well, that's what I'd like to know.
Mom, how you doing?
Ray. Ah, just goes on and on, doesn't it? Oh, hello, Father Leo. How nice to see you again.
Hello, Helen.
Well, I managed to put enough together to bail one of them out. Which one will we take?
Tough call.
I think we let Father Ray decide.
Please don't call me that.
Salvation. Eternal salvation. That's what I'm offering you.
No, Louis. No, okay? I'm not gonna do it. Well, Ray and Martin are away. My primary concern is to make sure that not one single disaster occurs.
Since when is letting people sleep in the church a disaster?
People? I thought it was just you we were talking about.
Me too, but the more I read this stuff, the more it gets to me.
Well, be careful, Louis. Read too much of that stuff, you might end up with a vocation. Now, if you'll excuse me.
But...
Help! Then he will say to those on his left, out of my sight, you condemned, into that everlasting fire prepared for the devil and his angels, for I was hungry and you gave me no food. I was thirsty and you gave me no drink. I had no home and you gave me no welcome.
Judge, you know my father. Fire chief, big brother, Knights of Columbus, Pop Warner coach, you name it, he's done it. He shot my brother.
Now, my brother, he's been in and out of trouble since he was old enough to walk. 3 different high schools, petty theft, drug abuse, 2 stretches in the pen. So there you have it. A hero and a bum. Or so it seems. Because what a lot of people don't know is my father is also a recovering alcoholic. And back in his old drinking days, he used to sound an awful lot like Mike. He had the same DUIs, the same fights, the whole 9 yards. But Mike! Mike has got more heart, more courage, more untapped potential than all of us put together. So it's a paradox. Look, my father wants to send Mike back to jail. But if Mike goes down on a 3rd strike, all of his potential goes with him too. So I'm just asking you, please, don't let that happen.
Paradoxes abound, Father. Meanwhile, laws are broken, lives are in danger. Your father says Mike will be better off in jail where less will be expected of him.
Right.
But in this case, I disagree. At least right now, jail is not the answer.
Thank God.
Father Ray, you work with a church that does extraordinary works of charity. Well, charity begins at home. I'm going to remand your brother to community service at your parish under your supervision.
What, you know, look, I can't do that. I've never been able to help him.
Well, you're going to have to. We seem to be addressing the oldest question in the Bible. Am I my brother's keeper? In this case, I can answer most definitively. Yes, you are.
All rise.
Well, it's nice to have the family together.